Luca Ingram and Tyson both said that a lot of work was done on offense today, kind of staying, get the movement going if you don't have the ball. What have you seen lately from that?
Well, you know, I feel confident that our team will be able to score the ball. And that's why we continue to preach defense and work on defense, because we want to be able to win games with our defense. And I think we did that. And we showed that in the Sacramento game, and we continue to make progress on that end. You know, as far as where we're at with the offense, you know, there's a lot of things we got to continue to clean up as far as the spacing, you know, the details of, you know, where we want to be, how to keep our flow moving. So we started practice today again with our defense, but gave a longer stretch of time with yesterday being off to working on some offense after we finished up that work.
Defense seemed fine the first couple weeks, but offense has been trouble lately. Are you waiting for the time when both offense and defense are clicking for a week or so?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's ideally what we're trying to get to, and we will get there, but, you know, we score a lot of points. You know, we get out and we run, and we got multiple guys who can go get buckets for us. So we'll continue to work, clean up execution of that, but we're going to continue to prioritize defense.
Luke, can you sense like the meshing is coming together? I mean, just the camaraderie of the guys here at practice and over the last week or so, it's kind of.
Yeah, it's been happening since even before training camp started. You know, the way the guys have been coming in most of the summer and working together, and you know, and then with the new guys we signed, once they started to get, you know, coming in and playing pickup and all those. So, you know, from a coach's standpoint, I could see that happening. And then it just takes time. And you know, we're still, you know, very far away from where we need to get to. But it's easier and it's more fun when you can feel what you're talking about happening. And it is happening, but we still, you know, we got a lot of work to do.
Are you aware that Tyson was also considering the Warriors before signing with you guys?
I was not aware of that, no.
You mentioned that earlier. Does it feel good, given kind of the riches they've amassed over the years, does it feel good to have somebody choose you over them?
No. It feels good that he chose us. I mean, I honestly, like I said when we got him, I don't know how all that works out. But our front office did a hell of a job bringing him in, and I'm happy he's here. It doesn't matter to me whether we got chosen over somebody else or not.
And I know you've been saying that you appreciate that he can help keep JaVale fresh and kind of solidify the system you guys use defensively throughout the rotations. Is there some management of, like, you know, JaVale was playing, you know, 30 minutes before you guys added Tyson? Maybe he enjoyed that role. I mean, is there some management?
No, we're a team. We're a team, and everyone, you know, our message all year has been, you know, whatever it takes for our group to get the job done. And that's going to be different guys stepping up. It's, you know, different guys in the starting lineup already. It's different guys finishing the games each night. And that the ultimate goal is the team. And that's what we, you know, continue to preach. So JaVale's fine with it.
I was looking at some numbers with Brandon last night. I noticed, like, last year, something like 65% of the assisted balls he would get on baskets came from bigs like Lopez and Randall and Larry when he was around and stuff like that. How much do you think the absence of those guys and, like, that type of front court players impacted the type of shots he's getting this year?
Well, it's, you know, that's why when you put, you know, new teams together, it takes time. You know, part of it is the way they played, but part of it is those guys get used to playing together. And he realizes, okay, when Julius is going down the post, he's drawing doubles now, so I'm going to cut off. Or Brooke, when he sets a pick and pop, the lane's going to be open. So, you start to feel where you're going to get your openings off of what your teammates' strengths are. So part of the answer to that question is, yeah, because of how Brooke and Julius played, he was able to get shots. And part of that is now figuring out, okay, what's JaVale doing that I can gain an advantage off of? And what's, you know, Kuz playing more minutes at the, you know what I mean? So it's a little bit of both.
So, like, his layup percentage or something like that is down this year relative to last. Is that a matter of, like, trying the same thing? It's not working as well this year and last year. Now you got to figure something different, or?
No, it was, again, it's a little bit of both of those. Yeah. It's part of that, Brook, when he's spaced out, there's more space for those layups. When Julius is plowing through the lane, he's taking two or three guys with him. And, you know, with JaVale, with his rolling, that draws a crowd with him. But it's a different type of cut to come off and score, or it's the timing on it can be different. So it's again, both of those things playing into account. That is why it takes time for groups to get together.
Similar stuff happening with Lonzo, too, with the amount of ball handlers. The amount of stuff just happens sort of all throughout the roster with those guys.
Yeah. It's new. Yeah, new guys learning to play together and what's best strengths and weaknesses of a group.
Back to Tyson and JaVale, how much does it help in terms of continuity, being able to have, you know, one of them pretty much at all times on the court?
It's been great. I mean, our you know, is having we've been we preach what we do on defense, and it ends with rebounding, and having one of those guys out there at all times gives us a much better chance of rebounding basketballs, protecting our rim. You know, we were bleeding points in the paint, we were bleeding offensive rebounds, and we've started to clean some of that up with being able to keep one of them out there at all times.
And how much does it help you in terms of just eventually getting to a set rotation, just, you know, having, you know, knowing that you can...
Yeah, I mean, it's nice for the continuity. Yeah. You know, groups start to build identities, they start to know what plays, you know, what to look for off of each other, and it's obviously getting a little more consistent right now, but it'll continue to change as the season goes. There's always going to be something going on.
How much of your three-game win streak and your improved defensive numbers when he's on the court is a direct correlation to Tyson Chandler joining you guys?
He's a big part of it, but a big part of it is also the guys have been putting in that work, and you know, we're still very early into the season before Tyson got here, and the rotations, the coverages, the terminology are all things that are going to get better when you have a group of guys that's willing to work and play for each other, and we have that group. I think bringing Tyson in, although it is a very big part of it, also just helps speed up what our guys were doing.
Were you guys doing healthy?
Huh?
Is everyone healthy in your team?
Yeah.
Just checking, because sometimes you sneak those unhealthy questions.
Yeah. No, everybody on our team is. Yeah.